We are the first German academic venture outside of Germany, which is quite important. So Germany is, I mean, we have 80 million people in our home country. So that's why the university is normally very busy to educate in Germany. And TUM was the first one to say, no, we go right away. We step out of Germany and we offer our degrees somewhere else. And this happened 10 years ago. So we started with chemistry. And now you are asking why there are TUM, NUS, TUM, NTU. We offer at the moment 5 master degrees, Master of Science, and 4 of these 5 are offered together with either NUS or NTU. Which means if you study, for example, integrated circuit design with us, you get a joint master degree of TUM and NTU. So this would mean the same, you get a TUM master degree, and at the same time, you also get an NTU master degree. So which gives you like a degree from both universities at the same place and at the same time. Speaking about TUM's linkages to industry, of course, this is also one of the advantages or one of the key things that we banked on from the beginning. Besides this, of course, being a part of Germany's number one university, we also very much focused on collaboration with like key government institutions. But of course, more importantly for you, is more like our industry linkages. Why is it important? I would say for 2 key reasons. I mean, we can ensure that the contents that we are teaching are really relevant. If you remember, what courses are we offering? I mean, we're offering chemistry. Germany is very strong in that. We're offering electrical engineering. Infineon, Bosch, Siemens, these are all key German companies. Of course, also very near to TUM. Aerospace, we are very strong, transport and logistics. I just heard a survey recently in terms of logistics ranking. In the past, Singapore was the leading country last year, but this year again, Germany overtook Singapore. So it's just like that these are the top key players also in terms of logistics. And if you look at the Singaporean industrial landscape, I mean, I don't have to tell you about the importance of the chemical cluster. Think of Jurong Island. The same for like the electronics cluster. And that's, of course, why this is a perfect match. We have 2 very strong partners in terms of academia, so the universities are outstanding. And, of course, also all the industrial partners are there, which makes it very easy also for our graduates to come, get a top-notch degree, and later, ideally, the companies, for the good guys, of course, the companies try to get them even before they're graduating. So we have 10 years experience on the master level. And if we look at the percentage of students getting a job before graduating, we can easily compete with NUS and NTU on that. Of course, our numbers are smaller, but the take-up rate and success rate of our students is at least the same. And what I understand, the salary is even a bit higher of what they get at NUS or NTU. To be honest, our degree might not really take only 2 years, so it might be a bit more than 2 years. So, of course, we give the poly kids a bit of advanced standing. So, especially in terms of like IT programming, internship, I think you guys already have quite some experience. But given the importance of German engineering education, we still put, okay, one thing to be very frank, I think what Germans really love is mathematics. So if you come and study engineering with us, this is very heavily based on math. But sorry, I mean, you cannot do electrical engineering without a solid, proper fundament in mathematics. No way can you ever be a proper good engineer. Also, what is a bit different here, we don't believe in teleteaching or video conferencing. And since this is a TUM degree, we also want to make sure that you get your fair share of TUM professors. So a lot of the modules will be done in some kind of block style of teaching. Overseas immersion program. Of course, this might also interest some of you. Of course, all of our students have to go to TUM. If you want a TUM degree, yes, you start studying in Singapore for most of the time, but at least for, I would say, around 4 to 6 weeks on average, for some maybe even longer, you have to go to TUM. And then, okay, we try not to bring you there when there's Oktoberfest, since you should study and not like party too much. Yeah, but I think actually it's around September, so you might be lucky, so it might be overlapping a bit with the Oktoberfest time. So this is a bit, so what you're then doing in TUM, of course you like will like work in the labs, you have the chance to engage with the professors over there, and you should also, at the end of our bachelor degree, you have to do your bachelor thesis. So this is like, depends how heavy you work per day, but can be up to 2 months plus, where you really like produce your first serious thesis work together with the scientists at TUM. So we might have even guys from the industry to come and share something with you, maybe even like come and teach in some of the modules. We also always arrange industry visits for our students so that you really get out and get to see, okay, what is Infineon, what is Siemens, what are other companies, maybe Shell, what are they doing here? What kind of personnel do they need? What kind of qualification do they need? Of course, it's good for you to have the academic expertise, but it's also very helpful that you understand from the companies what are their expectations. On the other side, the companies always find it very helpful to say, yes, we want to get in touch with the top students early. We don't want to wait until they graduate. We want to talk to them maybe earlier. You know, I mean, then pick the top students already and engage them for the company. So you start with the Bachelor Electrical Engineering, then you finish, and then you can continue with our Master in either IC Design and Microelectronics. And the Master, for example, is only 18 months instead of 2 years. Okay, 18 months means because there is no more break at all. So this is 18 months without any break. So we have 3 week study break over Christmas, and that's everything. The same goes for those guys who maybe go for chemical engineering and master in chemistry. Of course, and then after this, you can always continue with a PhD if you want. PhD here or PhD in Germany or PhD elsewhere. So this is always open. Well, I mean, why German engineering? If you have the choice, I don't think you go for an American or a British car. So maybe you go for an Audi or a BM or a Merz or a Porsche. And I mean, Audi and BM are more like both 30 minutes away from TUM. And if you look at the most reputable companies in the world, you have number 4, you have BMW. Like number 9, you have Volkswagen. And Audi and Porsche are both part of Volkswagen, for example. And this is unchanged over the years. So, I mean, there must be something behind it why the top, even the top students later are looking to work in companies like this.